Hello, my pupilos, and welcome to a new Spanish lesson with me, Sebas. Today, we'll continue with the verb videos, and the topic for today is the gerundio, and the way we use it on the present continuous in Spanish. And good news for you guys. I would have to say that you have to think a lot about this topic, because you know, the present continuous tense is almost the same in Spanish and in English. So, the present continuous in Spanish is formed by using the verb estar, the same way in English we use the auxiliary verb to be. Do you remember about the conjugation of the verb estar? If not, let's have a quick review. Yo estoy. Tú estás. Él está. Nosotros estamos. Vosotros estáis. Ellos están. And in the same way in English we have the ing termination, in Spanish we have the ando termination for the ar termination verbs, and the terminations yendo, yendo, and endo for the er and ir termination verbs. So, summarizing this tense structure, we just have to use the auxiliary verb estar plus the conjugation in the gerund form of the verb we wanna use. That's simple. For example, let's take the verb cantar. Yo estoy cantando. Tú estás cantando. Él está cantando. As you see, we just take the verb stem and then add the termination ando. And then we have the gerund form plus the conjugated form of the verb estar according to the person we're talking about. So now, let's see in which cases we use the present continuous in Spanish. As I told you before, this part is gonna be really easy as the present continuous is almost used the same way in Spanish and in English. Laura está cenando en estos momentos. Laura está cenando en estos momentos. Laura is having dinner at this moment. Diego y Carla están jugando tenis. Diego y Carla están jugando tenis. Diego and Carla are playing tennis. ¿Qué haces ahora? What are you doing right now? Estoy cocinando para el almuerzo, ¿y tú? I'm cooking for dinner, and you? ¿En dónde estás? Where are you? Estoy yendo a la universidad. I'm going to the university. Vivo en España, pero por ahora estoy viviendo en París. Vivo en España, pero por ahora estoy viviendo en París. I live in Spain, but now I'm living in Paris. Estoy leyendo El Señor de los Anillos. La historia me ha atrapado. Estoy leyendo El Señor de los Anillos. La historia me ha atrapado. I'm reading The Lord of the Rings. The story has caught me. Diana está rara últimamente. Creo que se está enamorando. Diana está rara últimamente. Creo que se está enamorando. Diana is weird lately. I think she's falling in love. Últimamente está lloviendo mucho. Últimamente está lloviendo mucho. Veo que estás llorando mucho últimamente. ¿A qué se debe? Veo que estás llorando mucho últimamente. ¿A qué se debe? I see that you're crying a lot lately. Why is that? Now, there's one case in which the present continuous is not used the same way in both languages. So, which use of the present continuous I'm missing? Got it! When we talk about the future. In Spanish, we would never say me estoy encontrando con mi papá mañana. No, no way. We would say me encontraré con mi papá mañana. I'm meeting my dad tomorrow. Y bueno, mis queridos pupilos, eso es todo por hoy. If you have any question, opinion, or recommendation, please go ahead and leave your comments below. And if you like this video, thumb up and subscribe. Soy Sebas y hasta la próxima.